Today we will be continuing our discussion on sampling distribution of X bar and the CSSP matrix. What we have proved so far is that the two estimators, sample mean and the sample CSSP matrix, are independent. So this we have proved, that O bar, S are independent. This also actually tells me that O bar, S by N are also independent. Now, the discussion of sampling distribution doesn't stop at independence. We would of course need to know what is the probability distribution of each of them. Okay, I don't know how many of you remember the definition of sampling distribution, but what do you mean by sampling distribution? Given any sample, you will get one value of O bar and one value of S by N. So if you have multiple samples, let's say I give each of you an exercise to collect some bivariate data. So each of you will get one value of O bar and one value of S by N. So at the end of the exercise, we would have 60 values of O bar and 60 values of S by N if our class size is assumed to be 60. So all those 60 values, if I plot in a histogram of say individual components, then I'll get some sense about distribution of O bar. Similarly, I can get some sense about distribution of S by N. Those distributions are actually known as sampling distributions. You know, in the univariate case, that if x1, x2, xn are normal, so this is known to you, if x1, x2, xn are iid normal mu sigma square, then we know that x bar also follows normal with mean mu and variance sigma square by n. This is known to you. Similarly, S square upon sigma square follows chi square. This is also known to you. Okay, chi square with how many degrees of freedom? So actually chi square with n minus 1 degrees of freedom, right? 1 degree of freedom is lost because in computing S square, you are subtracting the mean. So because of that, 1 degree of freedom is lost. And you further know that this X bar and S square are independent. So in the univariate setup, if someone asks you about sampling distribution of X bar, S square, these three things you tell them: that X bar also has normal distribution with mean mu, means the same mean, and the variance is sigma square by n. S square upon sigma square has chi square distribution with n minus 1 degrees of freedom, and X bar, S square are independent. So in the multivariate setup, so far we have done only part equivalent to this. So we are yet to do this as well as this. Now this is going to be homework. Why? Because it's quite easy. We have already proved a result in properties, that if I have, say, I think we had assumed y1, y2, yn coming from p variate normal. In fact, we had allowed means to be different, I think, so mu I. And also variances were allowed to be different. Then we know distribution of summation ai yi, I going from 1 to n, will again be normal if they are independent. Of course, independence needs to be assumed. Then summation ai yi, we have assumed, is summation ai mu I going from 1 to n, and ai square sigma I going from 1 to n. So we have done this, right? So using this result, can I prove that, so now my homework, let me write down clearly. Homework is, if you have O1, O2, On, each coming from p variate normal with mean mu and variance sigma, and their iid, so we are actually in a specific case. Here only independence was assumed, identical distribution was not there, whereas now I am assuming the distributions to be identical also. Then O bar will have p variate normal distribution again with same mu, mean mu, and variance sigma upon n. Okay, O bar will have mean, same mean mu, and variance sigma by n. Now as you can see, it is direct application of this result. I don't need anything else. So this is a homework. Okay, it's very easy. So if you complete your homework, then part equivalent to this will be done. So now I have to worry about this. Now what are the problems here? First thing, I knew, okay, if x bar is univariate normal, then in the multivariate setup, I knew I could expect multivariate normal. But I don't know what is the multivariate version of chi-square. Second problem, if x1, x2, xn were univariate, x bar was a vector. Here, s square is univariate. S square is a single thing. But now we don't have vector. In the multivariate setup, what I have is a matrix. So I need a matrix equivalent of chi-square. Not just the vector equivalent. So even if I get multivariate chi-square from somewhere, that may not be enough, because this in my case is now a matrix. This is also a matrix. So I need something of that type. Okay. So that's where this Wishart distribution comes into picture. Okay. So what is a Wishart distribution? Wishart distribution is actually equivalent of chi-square, but it is matrix version. So first of all, it is distribution on a matrix and it is equivalent to chi-square. Okay, what do I mean by matrix distribution? I don't know if you guys are following what I'm trying to say. So my CSSP matrix S is a matrix with entries say S11, S12, S1P and so on, SP1 up to SPP, because it's P cross P matrix. So each of these is dependent on sample. So each of these is a random variable. Hence, this is actually a random matrix. Okay. If you remember the discussion in the first week, we did define expectation of a random matrix. We didn't define variance of random matrix, but expectation we did define. So this S is actually a random matrix. Sigma will be a constant matrix, and I would try to do something about S and sigma. Of course, I cannot do S upon sigma because I cannot divide one matrix by other, but we'll try to do something similar to it. Okay, so that's where Wishart distribution comes into picture. And we are going to use the result that we proved in the last lecture for doing this. So what we did in the last lecture was, let me go back to the thing. Okay. So in the last lecture, we proved that O bar can be written as Wn upon root n, and this S matrix, CSSP matrix, can be written as sum over I going from 1 to n minus 1, Wi, Wi prime. And what do I know about Wi? I know that all those Wi's are independent. What else I know? I also know something about distribution of Wi's. Let me take you there. The statement of dilemma. Okay, yeah. See, this is a statement of dilemma. So what I know is Wi's are independent. This is my first part. And the second part was each Wi has p variate normal distribution with some mean vector and variance covariance matrix is constant. Okay, it is sigma across all i's. Okay, and when we related this to the CSSP matrix, actually every Wi had the same mean, because my original O1, O2, On had same mean. Each of my Wi's would also have the same mean. Okay, hence what we know is the CSSP matrix S. The CSSP matrix S can be written as S is equal to summation yi prime I going from 1 to n minus 1. Okay. I'm just using yi instead. Okay, let me stick to wi. No harm done. So S can be written as summation I going from 1 to n minus 1 wi wi prime. This is from the proof of earlier lemma. Okay, please go and check. So if I had O1, O2, On as iid vectors coming from p variate normal distribution, I could write s as sum of wi wi prime, where each wi has p variate normal distribution with mean mu and variance sigma. Okay, this I think we have not proved the mean mu part, but it I think you can take it as a homework. Okay, whether each wi has a same mean. Okay, wait, let me do that here. What I know is wi is sum over pij mu j, j going from 1 to n. This is my original definition of wi from the earlier lemma. Now what I know is each mu j is same, because my o1, o2, on are not just independent. In the lemma they were just independent, but now because I have a sample o1, o2, on coming from np mu sigma, each mu j is actually mu. So I have sum over j going from 1 to n pij mu, which actually turns out to be mu times sum over j going from 1 to n pij. And what do I know about this? I know that this p is an orthogonal matrix. Okay, so if p is an orthogonal matrix, can I say something about sum over j going from 1 to n pij? Yes, can I say that sum over j pij is 0? Why? In the usual orthogonal matrix setup, that need not be the case. But I know that in this particular setup, my P is a special orthogonal matrix. So what do I know about P? P is an orthogonal matrix with last row as 1 by root n. We had done that yesterday. Yesterday means the earlier lecture. 1 by root n, 1 by root n, 1 by root n. This I know. Okay. P is an orthogonal matrix with last row as 1 by root n, 1 by root n, 1 by root n. Okay. I know things might seem to be going a bit fast, but do refer to your earlier notes. It would be easy. What I am trying to do here is I am trying to write wi, and I know that this I am interested in only for I going from 1 to n minus 1, because this s consists of wi's I going from 1 to n minus 1 only. So my I is not going to n. Okay, I am stopping at n minus 1. So what I know is P is an orthogonal matrix, so dot product of any row with any other row would be 0. So if I take ith row of PSA PI prime into nth row of P. Okay, ith row, this is my notation for ith row of P. So this is nth row of P. So PI prime PN would become sum over j going from 1 to n pij, and nth row is just 1 by root n. So 1 by root n. Okay. Sum over j going from 1 to n pij 1 by root n. So this 1 by root n is anyway common. So this would be 1 by root n sum over j going from 1 to n pij. And what I know is P is an orthogonal matrix. So if I am considering I not equal to n, then this dot product must be 0. So what I get is sum over, what I get is sum over Pij is equal to 0, sum over j going from 1 to n. And this is true for every I up to n minus 1. So except for last row, this is true. As a result, this would become 0. So my expectation of wi is summation pij mu j. Okay, I had forgotten expectation earlier. Expectation of wi is summation pij mu j. So this would become a 0 vector. Is it okay? Just take a look at this part again. we started with expectation of wi, and expectation of wi can be written as summation pij mu j. I have each mu j as mu because I am talking of O1, O2, O n coming from p variate common multivariate normal. It would become mu summation pij, and just now we proved that summation pij is 0 for every I going from 1 to up to n minus 1. So expectation of wi is 0. Okay, this is an interesting result. So what we have done is, now from this and this, that S, the CSSP matrix, can be written as sum of squares and sum of products of n minus 1 independent multivariate normal vectors with mean 0, just now we proved mean 0, and variance covariance matrix as sigma. Okay, variance covariance matrix as sigma is already proved in the lemma. Okay, mean, we didn't have the exact form, we just wrote summation pij mu j, and in this particular case that summation pij mu j turns out to be 0. Okay, so S can be written as sum of squares and sum of products of n minus 1 independence is also important, multivariate normal vectors with mean 0. This is 0, okay, this is not O, and variance covariance sigma. So now we are going to define Wishart distribution as a distribution which has this type of property. Okay, so let me define Wishart matrix, which is same as a random matrix having Wishart distribution. Okay, just another way of writing the same thing, random matrix having Wishart distribution. So you can take this as definition of Wishart distribution also. Now I am writing a general definition, so technically my definition has nothing to do with CSSP matrix. Okay, a P cross P random matrix S, a P cross P random matrix S is said to have a Wishart distribution with parameters k and sigma, k is scalar, sigma is matrix, if it can be written as S equal to summation I going from 1 to k yi yi prime. Okay, if it can be written as this, where what are my yi's, my y1 y2 yk are independent p variate normal vectors with mean 0 and variance covariance matrix sigma. Okay, so a P cross P random matrix S is said to have a Wishart distribution with parameters k and sigma if it can be written as sum of yi yi prime, where yi's are independent and they have a common distribution, p variate normal distribution with mean 0 and variance covariance matrix sigma. This k is actually known as degrees of freedom. I said that this is equivalent to chi-square, so in chi-square your parameter is degrees of freedom, hence here also you have degrees of freedom. And the notation is, we write S follows Wishart, so WP with K sigma. So W stands for Wishart, okay, W stands for Wishart, P is giving you order of this S, S is P cross P, K k is the degrees of freedom that comes from this number of summands in this sum, and sigma is actually the common variance covariance matrix of these yi's. Okay, now using this definition, what can I say about my CSSP matrix? So I can actually say from the earlier figure, the earlier equation, let me call this a star. So from this star, what I know is CSSP matrix can be written as summation wi wi prime, where I goes from 1 to n minus 1. We have already proved independence. We have proved that mean is 0, and variance sigma has also been proved already. Therefore, using this, I can conclude that CSSP matrix follows Wishart distribution with n minus 1 and sigma. Okay, that is, for CSSP matrix, the degrees of freedom would be n minus 1 because the number of summands is n minus 1. We have w1, w2 up to wn minus 1, and variance covariance matrix is sigma. Okay, so we have proved that the CSSP matrix has some distribution which we are naming as Wishart distribution, and we know that it is equivalent to chi-square distribution. Why is it equivalent to chi-square? Because it's kind of generalization of chi-square. In fact, we'll see in the properties also. But even in the definition, you can see that chi-square comes from the sum of squares in the univariate normal setup. So here, we are doing sum of squares and sum of products in the multivariate normal setup. Hence, Wishart is generalization of chi-square. Now we have to see some properties of Wishart matrix or properties of Wishart distribution. You can call whatever you want. As I said, the equivalence of chi-square and Wishart can be seen in these properties also. So for all the properties, let me have S to be some Wishart matrix with degree of freedom K, and common the variance parameter as sigma and p variate. Okay, let me write down the first property. First property is, for every L in RP with L not equal to 0, L prime S L upon L prime sigma L will have chi-square distribution with k degrees of freedom. Okay, this is first property. For every L in RP with L not equal to 0, L prime SL upon L prime sigma L follows chi-square k. Now, let us try to see if I can prove this. What we know is that S matrix, because it's Wishart matrix, can be written as sum over I going from 1 to k yi yi prime. This is coming from definition, where yi's are iid normal with zero mean and variance covariance matrix sigma. Okay, this is known to us. Let us try to use it. Because yi's are iid normal, I can write L prime yi as iid normal with zero L prime, sorry, not vector zero, scalar zero, L prime sigma L. Okay, I can write L prime yi, and again this is for every I going from 1 to up to k. Okay, L prime yi is iid which normal, this is not w, okay, I'm sorry, this is n, normal with mean 0 and variance L prime sigma L. Because of this, I can write sum over L prime yi by sigma, if I call this as say sigma square, then this I going from 1 to n is 1 to k. What can I say about these? See, L prime yi is univariate normal with mean 0. If I divide by sigma square, then what can I say? Let me write as this way. Now, because yi is univariate normal with mean 0 and variance sigma square, yi upon sigma becomes standard normal yi upon sigma, we'll have standard normal distribution. As a result, L prime yi. As a result, this is nothing but sum of standard normal random variable squares. Okay. L prime yi upon sigma whole square is a square of standard normal random variable, and I'm taking sum over k of them, and they are independent. So I know that this follows chi square with k degrees of freedom from the univariate distribution theory. Okay, so that is exactly what I have. So I'm writing sum over I going from 1 to k. But when I say L prime yi square, actually I can't square L prime yi because, okay, fine, L prime yi, and I can write this as L prime yi upon sigma is square root of L prime sigma L, and I have to take square of it, follows chi square k. Okay, so what we have done is L prime yi square I have written as L prime yi into L prime yi. Sigma is L prime sigma L. So this we know is nothing but sum over I going from 1 to k. L prime yi is a scalar, so I can write it as transpose of itself. So this I will write as transpose L prime yi prime. Denominator is L prime sigma L, follows chi square k. This now becomes summation I going from 1 to k L prime yi, this becomes yi prime L upon L prime sigma L, follows chi square k. Okay, we know that L and sigma are constants, so they are free from I. So I can write this as L prime sigma I going from 1 to k yi prime L upon L prime sigma L. Okay, sum can be taken in. If you are not comfortable in taking sum in, you can write this whole thing, because it's a scalar, you can write it as trace of itself. Once it is trace, you can change the order. Okay, that is also okay. Chi square k. And now, because, so S is nothing but yi prime. So this is L prime SL upon L prime sigma L, and we have just now proved that it is chi square with k degrees of freedom. Okay, so we have proved the first property. We have proved the first property of Wishart distribution, that if you have L which is an RP, then L prime SL upon L prime sigma L is chi square with k degrees of freedom. And proof, as you can see, relies on property of univariate normal and chi square. That normal comes from sum of, chi square comes from sum of squares of standard normals. We are using that property. Okay. Let me go to the second property of Wishart distribution. So S matrix is already defined. S is a Wishart matrix with variance coefficient matrix as sigma. Now, let S and sigma be partitioned such that S can be written as S11, S12, S21, S22, where you know that these are variance covariance matrices, these are like CSSP parts, and sigma can be written as sigma 11, sigma 12, sigma 21, sigma 22. So sigma 11, sigma 22 are variance parts, and sigma 12, sigma 21 are covariance parts. We are aware of that. Okay, if this is the case, then actually I am going to say that S11, the property says S11 follows Wishart distribution. If this is say R cross R and this is say, T cross T suppose. Okay. So this is R cross T, this is T cross R, this is similar. Then S11 follows Wishart R with K and sigma 11. Similarly, S22 follows Wishart T with K and sigma 22. Okay, this is what the property says, that if S and sigma can be partitioned, then the partitioned matrices, the sub matrices which are along the diagonal, they also individually have Wishart distributions. Again, the proof of this property is quite simple. So what we know is S is Wishart. This is known to me. S is Wishart with K sigma. This is known to us. Of course, P has to be R plus T. Then only this would hold. Then we know, because of the Wishart definition, that S can be written as sum over yi prime, where each yi is p variate normal with mean vector 0 and variance coefficient matrix sigma. This is my definition of Wishart. Now, through the algebra of partition matrices and because of the properties of multivariate normal, we know that if I partition each yi as yi1, yi2, where this is r cross 1 and this is t cross 1, then we know each yi1 will have r variate normal distribution with mean 0 and variance sigma 11. Similarly, each yi2 will have t variate normal distribution with mean 0 and variance sigma 22. Okay, so this comes from properties of multivariate normal. Then this is what we want. We also know that S11 can actually be written as sum over yi1 prime, I going from 1 to k. I'm not sure if all of you are okay with it, but if you are not, try writing down. Okay, see, every yi prime I can write as yi1, yi2, and prime will be yi1 prime, yi2 prime. So we know that this is nothing but yi1, yi1 prime, yi, okay, this would be yi1, yi2 prime, this would be yi2, yi1 prime, and this would be yi2, yi2 prime. Okay, once I take sum inside, what I know is S11 is sum of this and S22 is sum of this. So it is pretty clear that S11 and S22 will also have Wishart distributions. K will remain the same because number of summands is same. Sigmas will change, sigma 11, sigma 22, and the degrees of, the dimension would also change because this is R cross R matrix, this is T cross T matrix. Is it okay? So this is the second property of Wishart distribution. Let me go to the third property. So third property of Wishart distribution is equivalent to the chi-square again. So we have additivity in chi-square. What does additivity in chi-square say? That if I have, say, two chi-square random variables and if they're independent, then their addition is also chi-square, okay? And the degrees of freedom are addition of the two degrees of freedom. So we have a similar result. So let S1 be p-variate Wishart with m degrees of freedom and sigma as the variance coefficient matrix. Let me call M1 because I don't want to bring in n. N we reserve for sample size. And then S2 be Wishart with M2 sigma. Further, let me assume that S1 and S2 are independent. Okay, because S1 and S2 are again random, right? We are talking of random matrices, so we can define their independence. Then we will conclude that S1 plus S2 would also have Wishart distribution with M1 plus M2 and sigma. Okay. Let us first check a couple of things. First thing is, my S1 and S2 should have same order, then only I can add them. Okay? If they have different orders, of course addition won't make sense. So, you have to be sure that both of these are of same order. Secondly, they should have common sigma. Otherwise, the result won't hold. Okay? So, this is known as additivity. In chi-square, you generally don't worry about sigma because chi-square comes from sum of squares of standard normal. So, when you say standard normal, of course, everyone is having variance 1. Hence, you don't have equivalent of this, you know, common sigma in chi-square. Okay, independence you need in chi-square also, so here also. Again, the proof is quite simple. What I know is S1 is WP mu M1 sigma. So, therefore, S1 can be written as sum over I going from 1 to M1 yi prime, where each yi is p variate normal with mean 0, variance covariance matrix sigma. Okay, S1 can be written as yi prime by definition of Fishart matrix. Similarly, S2 can be written as sum over j going from 1 to m2, let me say wi prime, where each wi is p variate normal with mean 0, variance covariance matrix sigma. Okay, now you can see here easily, okay, let me write independence also just to make things clear. Everyone knows, but still. So we can see here that yi's and wi's both have same distribution. Okay, further, yi's are independent among themselves, wi's are independent among themselves. And it is given to us that s1 and s2 are independent. As a result, each yi must be independent of each wi or wj. Why I write j? So that we should not forget that when I say each yi is independent of each wj, I am not talking about just y1, w1, y2, w2, etc. I am talking of y1, w2, y2, w1 also. So all pairs are independent. Why? Because if suppose y1 and w2 are dependent, then that would make S1 and S2 also dependent. Getting it? If Y1 and W2, let's say, are dependent, then S1 is a function of Y1 and S2 is a function of W2. So that might imply that S1 and S2 are also dependent. Hence, if S1 and S2 are independent, then these Y's and W's are also independent. Therefore, I can define a new set of vectors, say V1, up to Vm1 plus m2, such that I define vi as yi when I is from 1 to up to m1 and vi as wi, not w, okay, let us change the notation a bit, when I goes from m1 plus 1 to m1 plus m2. So, when I have m1 plus 1, I need w1. Okay. So, I minus m1. Okay. Actually, the thing is very simple. We are just complicating it because we are introducing a notation. What I am trying to say is, collect all these yi's and wj's together. So, total, I will have m1 plus m2 vectors, each having the same distribution. That I am trying to write formally here. That define first m1 vectors as y1, y2, ym1. And then after that, we start with W1, W2. So, the m1 plus 1th vector would be W, m1 plus 1 minus m1. So, W1. m1 plus 2nd vector would be W2 and so on. Okay. And then, S1 plus S2 would become sum over I going from 1 to m1 plus m2 vi vi prime. Okay. Because yi prime also have to substitute vi, and wi prime also can be substituted by vi prime, where each vi is p variate normal with mean 0, variance covariance matrix sigma. Therefore, this is definition of Wishart. Hence, s1 plus s2 follows Wishart with m1 plus m2 degrees of freedom and sigma matrix. Okay, and now one more property. So we have two, three properties. Let me go to the last property of Wishart, fourth property. So let A be M cross P matrix with M less than P and M is rank. Okay, M is rank and M is less than P. Then A S A prime will also have Wishart distribution but with M dimension, same degrees of freedom, and A sigma A prime. Okay. First, let us try to understand necessity of this M less than P and M as rank. If M is greater than P, then AS A prime will have order M cross M, which is greater than P cross P, so it would become singular. So I need non-singularity, so I need this to be non-singular. For that, I need these two conditions. Okay, these two conditions imply that M A sigma A prime is non-singular, otherwise it won't hold. Okay. Now, can you visualize the proof? I think it should be easy to visualize. Again, we are going to use properties of multivariate normal. What I know is S can be written as sum over I going from 1 to k yi prime, where I goes from 1 to up to k, that is fine, where each yi is p variate normal with mean 0, variance sigma. This is normal. Okay, we know from properties of multivariate normal distribution that AYI will also be IID and they will have mean 0 because A mu, so 0, and A sigma A prime. Okay, this were proved using MGF in the very first lecture on properties of multivariate normal. Okay, as a result, A S A prime, when I try to write, it is going to be sum over I going from 1 to k, A sitting here, yi prime, A prime. I can bring A inside. So this becomes sum over I going from 1 to k, A, yi prime, A prime, which is nothing but sum over I going from 1 to k, A yi into A yi prime. Okay, and because we know that each A yi has normal distribution with this A sigma, okay, A sigma A prime, by definition of Wishart, I can conclude that A S A prime will have dimension changes. So M variate Wishart distribution with K, because K is same, and A sigma A prime. Okay, so this also comes from property of multivariate normal. So this is fourth property. We have proved that if I have a Wishart matrix and if you multiply it by some other matrix, pre and post multiply by a matrix and its transpose, then you again get a Wishart matrix. Of course, the dimension has to be such that the final variance coherence matrix A sigma A prime is non-singular. Okay. So here we'll stop our discussion on Wishart distribution. We are going to need this distribution later in testing of hypothesis. Hence, these properties would be useful there.